Exodus chapter 16, verses 11 to 21. The Lord said to Moses, I have heard the murmurings of the Israelites. Speak to them, saying, At twilight you shall eat meat, and between the two evenings you shall be filled with bread, and you shall know that I am the Lord your God. In the evening quails came up and covered the camp, and in the morning the dew lay round about the camp. And when the dew had gone, behold, upon the face of the wilderness there lay a fine, round, and flake-like thing, as fine as frost on the ground. When the Israelites saw it, they said one to another, Manna, what is it? For they did not know what it was. And Moses said to them, This is the bread which the Lord has given you to eat. This is what the Lord has commanded. Let every man gather of it as much as he will need, an omer for each person, according to the number of your persons. Take it, every man, for those in his tent. The people did so and gathered, some more, some less. When they measured it with an omer, he who gathered much had nothing over, and he who gathered little had no lack. Each gathered according to his need. Moses said, Let none of it be left until morning. But they did not listen to Moses. Some of them left it until morning, and it bred worms, became foul, and stank. And Moses was angry with them. They gathered it every morning, each as much as he needed, for when the sun became hot, it melted. Hear what the Spirit says today.
Thanks be to God.
and fly to Jesus. Fly to Jesus. Fly to Jesus. And fly to Jesus. Fly to Jesus. Fly to Jesus. And live.
Well, you heard the reading today, and we're still in our Lenten series about getting fit. So notice getting fit is a process. You know, it's not just something that happens overnight. Because most of us don't get out of shape overnight. So getting back into shape usually doesn't happen overnight. Now, I know there are surgeries to correct all sorts of things, but most of the time, even then, you got to have a healing process. And it doesn't just happen. So I want to share with you the only thing that God would give me for today, and I want to go ahead and tell you, I'll preface it with this, I argued with God and argued with God on this sermon. Because I did not really like what God was telling me about me. So, you know, I just have to go ahead and confess. And so I'm just going to do what I always do and share my part of the journey and invite you to come along with me. And if it hits you, well then, blame it on God. If you want to blame it on somebody, blame it on God. You heard the scripture today about Moses telling God's people, the Israelites, that they were going to have food supplied to them. Well, that sounds pretty good, doesn't it? If you're going to have food supplied to you, what if somebody came up to you and said, you don't have to go shopping anymore. You don't have to spend any money. I'm going to take care of all your food bill. You don't have to shop for it. You don't have to fix it. It'll just show up at your door every day. That sounds pretty good. That really sounds pretty good. I could go for that.